Hello everybody, I'm Sankalp and I'm going to present a brief summary of the work which we have been doing lately for tonic identification. So the title of our paper is Tonic Identification System for Hindustani and Carnatic Music, co-authored by Justin Salomon and Javed Sera. So before we proceed to what are our aims, it's very important us to understand what is the meaning of tonic in the context of Indian music, and that I guess is quite clear by now with many presentations on the same topic. So the tonic, as Ashwin explained, is a bass pitch chosen by the performer in order to explore the full vocal range. And usually this pitch is anchored as a sa swara in a raga rendition, and all the other pitch values used in the performance derive their meaning and context to some extent with respect to this reference, and all the accompanying instruments are tuned to the tonic of the lead performer. And so therefore it's very important for the performer and the audience to continuously hear this pitch throughout the concert, and that is precisely what is being done by a drone instrument, which is typically either tanpura, its electronic analog, surpeti, or the sympathetic instrument, sympathetic instincts for the case of sitar. And because we'll be talking a lot about different tunings of the tanpura, it's important for us to just at least know what are the typical tunings. Tanpura typically has four strings, and these are tuned as pa, sa, 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 and the sa with these marks are the one octave higher with respect to the first sa, as you can see it here. Either ma sa 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 or ni sa sa sa. So this is the lower octave sa and middle octave sa, and this is tuned to the tonic of the singer. And it's it has a unique characteristic because there is a thread inserted between the string and the bridge of this instrument, which creates this kind of buzzing and rounded sound. It's called jawari. So our goal is basically we have a large database of Indian art music, and we want to label it with the tonic. And for that, we propose to devise a system which will tell us like tonic pitch for vocal excerpts. And as of now, we estimate tonic pitch class profile, which is like we can treat it as sa for most of the cases. Only the exceptions are madhyam shruti cases for instrumental excerpts. And what we aim is not just to use audio data for identifying the tonic, but same time use all the available metadata which we have collected and stored in Music Brains. And we just don't want a value from the system. We want a confidence measure which will tell us like how confident the system is in identifying this tonic, so that we can put a threshold and decide whether we want to use that value in further analysis or not to stop like propagation of error. And motivation is quite clear, like it's a fundamental information that we need for many analysis like intonation analysis, raga recognition, and melodic motive analysis. As far as like relevant work goes, there's not much work being done like relatively on this problem. There are like a couple of papers which talk about tonic identification and basically using the melodic characteristics. There's recently a very nice paper by Ranjini et al. Which talks about identifying tonic using the melodic characteristics in Carnatic music, because we all know like the extent to which sa and pa has gamakas is lower than as respect to the other notes. And so when you look at the histogram, melodic histogram, you see sharp peaks, and they fit like Gaussian distribution to these peaks, and using the parameters of the Gaussian, they identify whether this peak is a tonic or not. So like just to summarize every past work, like they have focused on melodic aspects, mostly used like monophonic pitch trackers, whereas the data is actually heterophonic. And the database used for the evaluation of this method is really like limited, as in like they have used special raga categories or only alap sections or solo vocal recordings, etc. So as we see, like there's a huge scope of using other information, which I'll explain in coming slides, like background audio content, which heavily contains this drone sound. And also like the metadata which we have stored, like information regarding the gender of the singer, male, female, etc. And to evaluate on a sizable database. So this is basically the system which we propose. We start with the data like audio plus metadata which we have in MusicBrainz, and it's an iterative system and incremental system. So we take all the data, module decides what data to pump into automatic tonic identification module, and based on the iteration, like in which iteration we are, it decides like how much data do we need. For example, we start from like, this is just a proposal, we start from 30 second audio clip, we put it to automatic tonic identification, and it outputs tonic value as well as confidence value. So if the confidence value exceeds our defined threshold, to be safely treated this tonic as a good estimation, we terminate the loop here. Otherwise, we keep on adding more and more data, like increasing the audio length or putting in metadata like information regarding the gender and whether it's a Hindustani or Carnatic, etc. And if we have consumed all the data, just we terminate the loop and we say like, okay, this has to be done manually. I mean, system is not able. So this way, like we actually can, we need not output every result, but whatever we output is like fully confident, in order to like just stop error propagation in other problems. So what we want to do for tonic identification is to use culture specific characteristics like presence of drone, melodic characteristics. As we have already seen, sa and pa contents like the extent of gamakas is not that much, raga knowledge if possible, or melodic motives. Because if we identify some motive, we know like with respect to the tonic, what would be the distance, or like the if you know the motive, we can identify the tonic, and use variable amount of data that is just sufficient to identify tonic with maximum confidence. So like I've been talking that it becomes relatively easy when the drone is present. Let's see an audio example for this. This is a solo vocal recording. It's full. And to identify tonic here it's not that easy. I think this is the tonic. Whereas if we see like the same recording with a tanpura in the background, it's clear like this is the tonic. So we really want to utilize the background drone sound to identify the tonic, and so we want a representation that is meaningful enough which reflects what we want to do. And definitely pitch tracking won't be sufficient, because it will track either the most salient pitch or even if we do multiple pitch, it has multiple strings, so we are not sure we'll be getting sa. And so we chose to like apply multi-pitch analysis on this signal, and this is the block diagram explaining the main signal processing modules involved. We have three main stages: sinusoid extraction, pitch salience computation, which is a fuzzy kind of representation in which all the pitched content is highlighted, and a tonic candidate generation using this fuzzy representation. And we have audio, and we finally get tonic candidates. So I'll just quickly go over each module very quickly, as these are typical modules in any signal processing scenario. So we have audio signal. Here are the typical parameters listed just for a reference. And we get a time frequency representation. From this time frequency representation, we estimate the spectral peaks which are above a threshold, and we consider them as sinusoids. Because the resolution of these sinusoids is limited by the STFT resolution, we do a parabolic interpolation and improve the accuracy. And from these sinusoids, we do a harmonic summation to get this kind of representation, which is a fuzzy multi-pitch representation. And we see we get melody as well as the tanpura signal this is a flat, you don't see a third dimension, which is actually the salience of these pitch values. So we see both melodic contours and the straight Tanpura signal. And because the Tanpura is always present, always, and while the melody is moving in the pitch space, if we just sum this, we'll get like high values on the points where the pitches are present. But in doing so, we should be taking, we should have in mind that melody is far more prominent as respect to, with respect to the drone. And so we need some kind of normalization. So what we do is, in a given range, 110 to 550 hertz, we just take five most salient pitch candidates and we just drop the salience values. So no matter if it's a melody or if it's a Tanpura, the contribution in the histogram is equal. And now the task is, from this histogram, how do you extract the tonic pitch value? And we subdivide this task into two subtasks. One is identifying the pitch class of the tonic, and the other one is identifying in which octave it belongs to. And we use this, the multi-pitch representation, multi-pitch histogram, which we have extracted for the first thing, and for the establishing the octave, we use a prominent melody extraction approach proposed by Justin Salomon, and then apply heuristics as well as a basic machine learning techniques to extract the tonic. So like when we see the multi-pitch histogram, it looks something like this. We have nice peaks, but then to one of the peaks corresponds to the tonic pitch class and which we want to identify. We apply a classification based template learning. We want to learn a template using which we'll be able to say which of these peaks is actually the tonic pitch class. So what we do is, because everything, as we say, like is respect to the tonic, by understanding the relationship between these peaks, we should be able to boil down, like identify the tonic. So we do a peak picking on this histogram. I'm just showing five peaks, but we actually pick up 10 peaks. We see what is the distance between the topmost peak to the other peaks, which is like F1, F3, F4 respectively, and also the amplitude ratios. So we land up getting 20 features for every pitch histogram. Then using these 20 features and a class, which is what is the rank of the highest tonic pitch class. If the tonic pitch class is this, we say it's the first. If it was this, we say it's the fourth, and so on. And we use J48 classifier to learn a basic rule which will maximize the probability in a way that we learn this template. So this is the kind of decision tree that we get. As we see, like all the relationships are logical, like, and they are musical. The difference between sa and pa, sa and ma, like they are in terms of semitone. And these are the kind of scenarios we have, like, because two strings of the Tanpura are tuned to the same pitch class, that is sa, in different octaves. Majority of the times we get a situation like this, where the highest and the second highest peak is both sa. So as you'll see, like if the difference is greater than five, we choose the first one, which is the sa. And similarly, even if the highest peak is pa, we land up choosing the sa. So this was for the pitch class identification. And for octave identification, we look at the melody histogram, not the multi-pitch histogram. And we have a tonic pitch class, and we want to know what is the correct octave. So if we look here, like without any doubt, we can say like this is the correct octave, because this was the last sa used by the singer, the lowest sa used by the singer. And basically, we need to learn this shape in order to identify the correct octave. So we try both rule-based approach, in which I take for every pitch class, I take the ratio of that pitch class by the ratio of previous pitch class. So for whatever pitch class that is maximum will give me the correct octave. And I also tried a classification based approach where I take 25 features, which are the amplitude ratios at 25 equal distance points, basically to learn this shape. Regarding the database, I take 238 vocal recordings and 114 instrumental recordings. And for the excerpts which are more than 12 minutes long, I take three clips. So finally, I have 364 vocal excerpts and 176 instrumental excerpts. And I use these 540 excerpts for evaluating my pitch class algorithm and 238 recordings for evaluating the tonic algorithm, octave algorithm, because I need full recordings in order to establish the correct octave, because towards the end it might be the case that the singer would have sung the lowest note. This is just to get some statistics of the database. This is the distribution for females, typical tonic, and male-female ratio, and how many Hindustani and Carnatic pieces. Regarding the annotations, like I did it, and I think Vignesh verified them. And just to speed up the process, what we did was we extracted five candidates in the same way as I talked, and we came up with this a very basic MATLAB GUI which loads these five candidates. You can listen to the tone corresponding to these five candidates simultaneously, the music, and can annotate it and save the file. Regarding the accuracy measures, we consider output as correct if it is within 50 cents of the ground truth. We did both tenfold and rule-based classification. We used Weka for machine learning part, and for reducing the features, for the feature selection, we used Weka again, and we used features which are reported, like which are used in 80% of the folds. Used J48 decision trees. Like, we have tried a couple of other classifiers, but because of the type of the data, J48 was giving far better results. So these are the results, and the highest accuracy we achieved using just a single feature and single fold, of course. And we see, like, interesting thing here to see is if we normalize the class, the number of instances per class, we get less accuracy, because like in order to try to learn a data of the minority class, we actually make more confusions in the majority class, and so we end up getting a low result for that. And these are the type of errors we get mostly like either the fifth or the fourth. Instead of identifying the sa, we identify the pa or the ma. And for our octave identification, we achieve almost 100% accuracy, and even a rule-based approach yields 99% result. So some discussions, like when we observed the type of errors, we found that most of the errors are happening for female singers and the situations where there is ma tuning. So we dig into it, and we found that most of the data, like most of the recordings, have pa tuning. And for we learn rules to identify sa from this type of scenario. We learn rule to identify sa from this type of scenario. We choose this one. And so when this scenario happens for male singer, we are able to identify the sa. But what happens for the female singers is this goes beyond 550 hertz, and which was the range we have considered. And we basically, this scenario becomes identical to this one, and we pick this because we have learned to pick that, and we make this kind of error. We choose ma as the sa. And for the octave identification, there were few challenges we faced for, like, while doing a rule-based approach, which was due to because the melody extraction algorithm is not always perfect, and sometimes it misses tracking the notes which are very low and the sa, so we don't have any energy in that region. And also there is a concept of Madhyam Shruti in which the actual, if you talk sa of the Tanpura, it's not sung. It's like with respect to the sa of the Tanpura, it's the ma, which is the sa of the performer. So he's actually not going that below the sa. And as conclusions, we see like the drone signal has provides a very important cue, and we can use it to automatically identify the tonic. And we need some more information to feed system whether to say, like, whether it's a ma tuning or pa tuning. And I think in future there should be more interesting studies studying the influence of cultural background, like what kind of cultural information you need in order to identify the tonic, and a deeper analysis on confidence measure concept. And these are the references. Thank you.